If you're trying to find a job in data analytics and feel like you're firing resumes out into the void right now, this video is for you. I'm Seb Morgan, and I'm a careers coach with over 8 years of experience in career development and education. And in this video, I'll show you how you can translate your skills and achievements into a professional resume that employers will actually want to pick up and read. And because no one wants to spend all day fiddling with margins and formatting, you can use one of our free templates to do everything. You can download it right here from our website if you want to follow along. So save it to your desktop and join me when you're ready. Correctly formatting your resume is a must if you want to come across as professional and sincere, but to land an interview, you'll need to work the right specifics into your application. So we need to talk to a real data analyst if we're going to find out what we need to include. Midori, can you introduce yourself?
Yeah, I'm Midori. I'm an SEO data analyst at Resume Genius, specializing in SEO and marketing strategy.
Midori has experience on both sides of the hiring manager's desk. She's written job-winning data analyst resumes, and she knows exactly what to look for when reviewing other applicants for analyst jobs. And when we met, she told me exactly what goes into the perfect analyst resume. So how do we get started? Your resume introduction is kind of like the abstract at the start of a research paper. It gives a quick overview of what your resume contains, what is important, and what the employer should focus on. Most introductions are between 30 and 60 words long. That's 2 to 3 sentences normally. It's not a lot of space for you to get your message across, which is why I find the I am framework so helpful. Begin with a sentence summarizing your identity, you know, your profession or a key strength or where you are in your career. Then drop in an achievement that reflects your expertise and the motivation that drove you to apply, which could be something that you really like about the hiring company or a specific value that you know you can deliver the hiring team.
I think like the best a resume introduction can do is be unnoteworthy.
Be unnoteworthy?
Yeah.
Okay.
So that the hiring manager starts reading your work experience.
Right.
Just don't do anything wrong.
You're saying like don't write anything like too descriptive or like fluffy.
Any description of your achievements in detail should go in the cover letter or work experience section.
Mm-hmm.
The resume introduction should just be short, sweet, hit all of the check marks and then move on.
Mm-hmm. The aim is to just give the employers a glimpse of what makes you a great candidate. You'll go into more detail with the next section. Your work experience should tell a story, and one of the best ways to build a strong narrative is to give each job entry relevant context and focal points. So, what do you look for when you're reviewing a candidate's work experience?
I'm looking for proof that they know what this job looks like instead of broad, vague statements like worked with large data sets. Can they get into the nitty gritty of utilized Python to get data from API endpoints straight into BigQuery?
So you're saying like use language that demonstrates your familiarity with the topic.
Yes,
right?
And with every step of the topic, as specific, as concrete as possible. Not buzzwordy, but if you were clear on the process of it, then that would be a huge plus. Because you're also talking to someone who's presumably in the industry.
Yeah.
So name dropping is fine.
Use the first bullet point of each job to briefly outline your role at the company. Really try to boil down the work you did to a single statement. Your remaining 3 to 4 bullet points should focus on specific wins that highlight your ability to do the job or emphasize your expertise. Would you say, is it better for an applicant to list daily responsibilities or should they really focus on like the achievements they're most proud of?
I would say go with the one that's most applicable to the job description. Which one do they want?
Right, yeah. So know the job description and then write your achievements to reflect the
stuff
which matters the most.
And also, I guess, any fundamentals. I think with like this last round of hiring, something I was specifically looking for was data sanitation. If someone else had a resume that mentioned it, but yours didn't, I might go with theirs first.
Okay, cool. Having a relevant degree in a field like mathematics, statistics, or computer science is always helpful in data analytics, and it will help you stand out. So make sure you include your degree title, name of the college you went to, and your graduation date or expected graduation date if you're still in school. A solid GPA will always help your case, so include it if you received a 3.5 or above. Should applicants include coursework or school projects in their resume?
Coursework and schoolwork are probably more relevant to big companies because they're likely modeled off of big company workflow, like industry standards, right? Whereas for smaller companies, I think a more active problem-solving approach would probably appeal more. So I guess the question is, are those industry standards in some ways? And if so, for which companies, for which types of companies? And if you are applying to those types of companies, great. You got something that will appeal to them. If not, eh.
Yeah.
And I know what you're wondering. Yes, you should include your degree, even if you're entering data analytics from a non-STEM field, especially if it helps you develop transferable skills that could be relevant to non-technical aspects of the job.
Because I know that your background is not, like, you didn't study a STEM subject, you studied liberal arts.
Yeah.
Was there any school projects you included on your resume that helped you get this job, you think?
Helped me get this job? Even though my formal academic experience was in the liberal arts, one of my part-time jobs was very science-focused, and I did a lot of research for my degree. I definitely added them on my resume for this job, since I know it would be research analysis heavy. So I would hope that those two things made my resume more attractive.
A lot of applicants tend to go ham on the skills section, and let me tell you, those super long bullet points aren't impressing anyone. Anything you throw in here needs to be relevant and backed up with evidence elsewhere on your application. So really ask yourself which skills the employer will be interested in. We actually have a list of the top 10 skills US employers look for in data analysts. So don't worry, they're all right here if you want to have a look.
Should candidates focus on niche technical skills, or do you think it's better to present well-rounded, soft and hard skills?
I would say put any foundational technical skill that you didn't explicitly get to mention, but you feel would be an industry standard enough that you would probably be using it in this job, like MySQL, Excel, whatever.
Oh, by the way, keep soft skills off your shortlist. Buzzwords like communication, teamwork, or interpersonal skills really don't tell the employer anything of value. They need to be demonstrated through examples, not a bulleted list.
Speaking of skills, do you care about seeing soft skills in a skills section?
No, don't put them there. Don't put communication skills there. Any soft skills are going to come across in the interview phase more. So focus on getting technical skills on your resume. However, I will say, if you have data communication experience, put them not in the skills section, but in the work experience bullet points.
So an achievement about, you know, how you visualize data or presented it or, okay.
Yeah, because one downfall for a lot of candidates is that they know how to run the numbers, they can generate a report, but they can't point out what's important for stakeholders. If you have experience doing that, please put it on the resume.
You'll need a project section if you don't have previous data analyst work experience. Analytics is pretty technical, so your resume is going to need some kind of evidence that shows the employer you know what you're doing.
So what specifics should an applicant include if they're adding a project to their resume?
If possible, and it should be, give your hiring manager access to dashboards. Let them play around to see what exactly you made. The next level up would be, who is this dashboard or report meant for? And I think that would be a lot more useful to any hiring manager.
And that's gonna mean that you're gonna work more efficiently with, like, non-technical members of the team, with sales, with marketing, with just everybody else in an organization.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And in the age of Coursera, it's good if you can finish an online class and do a project, but if 100 other people also do that, how can you demonstrate that you're thinking beyond the instructions?
If you'd like more ideas, we've got plenty of other data analyst resume examples on our website to spark your inspiration.
Any words of encouragement for our data analyst applicants? Like, what's one thing they should take away from this video? Just anything.
Just keep on trucking. It sucks. Work hard. I would say the main takeaway is to be specific wherever possible. Be specific about the tools you've used. Be specific about what you made dashboards or reports for. Because I think, like, everything you mention on your resume is an attempt at throwing a dart and hoping it hits something in that company's workflow or tech stack. So it's always going to pay off to try to be specific, even if it misses just a little.
You have the right foundation, so you're gonna be easy to train.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for answering my questions today.
Thank you for asking me questions. Yeah. Feels so qualified.
And that's a wrap.
Hopefully this back and forth has helped take some of the mystery out of writing a data analyst resume. It still takes some effort, but you can now focus your energy on the parts that matter most for landing the role. All right, you've got this. I'll see you in our next video.